Live from Larry Kelly Field here at Daytona Stadium in Daytona Beach, Florida. Game number 8 for the Daytona Soccer Club hosting FC Miami City. We thank you for joining us on our YouTube live stream here. I'm Nick Gimble with all of the play-by-play action here on this Friday evening match. FC Miami City, the visiting team, at the top of the Southeast Division standings, a 5-2-1 record, 16 points on the season, 11 goals for, and 7 goals against. On the other side, Daytona SC coming off of a victory against Weston FC. Adam Abdullawi with a penalty kick goal late in the second half, giving Daytona that 1-0 victory. 3-1-3 record, 12 points on the season so far for Daytona. This is the first game of that second half, taking us down the latter part of this 2019 season. Daytona is one game behind everyone else in the Southeast Division. This is game number 8. They've played 7 games so far on this 2019 campaign. Everyone else in that Southeast Division is up to 8 games. This will be the 9th game of the season for FC Miami City. 5 goals for and 4 goals against in those 7 games for Daytona. Not a lot of goal scoring up front, but not nearly as many goals given up as the rest of this Southeast Division. That 4 goals against in 7 games is the best in the entire Southeast Division. Great for that defense and goalkeeping of Paul Harbrecht, who will once again get the start in the frame for Daytona SC. Daytona in their home full neon kit, the neon green shirt, pants, and socks, will be moving right to left across your computer screen. Meanwhile, FC Miami City in their road uniforms, the white top and the navy blue pants and socks, moving in the opposite direction, left to right across the field surface from your vantage point for those of you watching us back home. FC Miami City will have opening possession. Jeremy Costa will be in the net in the red jersey and black pants and socks for FC Miami. Meanwhile, Paul Harbrecht in that orange top with the black bottoms, and we are underway from Larry Kelly Field here in Daytona Beach. All the way back will be the captain for FC Miami, Josiah Trimmingham. He'll move it all the way to the left side of the field. Miami all the way back in their keeper box, trying to get everything sorted out. Starting on the field for Daytona SC, Lee Flowers, Adam Abdullawi, Irakoze Donaciano, Joe O'Sullivan, Shandell Sr., Mike Zamore, Ian McCauley, Kwaku Dwamena, Andreas Jackson, and Brock Exline. Starting out for FC Miami City will be Fajardo, Hernandez, Uwad, Gill, Martins, Peralta, Campbell, Sarugue, Trimmingham, and Urso. Daytona doing a good job of keeping the ball in their attacking half, and they will steal the ball away. Donaciano will settle it down for Daytona, brought all the way back to the captain for Daytona, Andreas Jackson. Back again to that left side. Daytona had that favorable left side at the start of the season, and a takedown there on the left side, your near side. And it will be a free kick for Daytona just over that midfield line. Brock Exline will take it for Daytona. On the bench to start this match for Daytona, including Angel Lombardo, Justin June, Craigton Charlton, Nate Monsanto, Sam Coombs, Nelson Puskin, and David Bucarelli. Adam Abdullawi is the leading goal scorer for Daytona. He got his second goal of the season on a penalty kick late in the second half against Weston FC. As this ball from Miami FC will go all the way under possession for Daytona, all the way back to Harbrecht, and he'll have to send it back out towards midfield. Looking back in the last 5 games for Daytona, all the way back on May 20th, was their last win before they got the win against Weston, as Daytona now is able to steal the possession away and are in the attacking third. Andreas Jackson sends it all the way through, but an offside call, and it would have been a save anyways, as Joe O'Sullivan sent that in on goal with the right foot. It was a 1-0 win against Sarasota Metropolis, and then a 1-1 tie against this very same FC Miami. So neither team really having the upper hand coming into this match tonight. And then it was a 2-0 loss against the Villages the last time Daytona was home in USL League 2 action. They followed that up on June 8th with a 0-0 tie at Florida Elite. And then, as we just mentioned, on June 19th, that 1-0 victory against Weston FC. Daytona will follow those five games up with their next five games all at home. Tonight against FC Miami City, who they beat 1-0, they tied 1-1 last time they met on May 29th. Then on Tuesday, June 25th, our next broadcast will be against Lakeland right here in Daytona. That was Daytona's first game of the season that came at a 1-1 tie all the way back on May 11th. As this ball is thrown well into the box, and FC Miami will get it back out down their left side of the field. Good speed from Miami, but better defensive posture from Lee Flowers, and he'll send it out of play. Back home again, Saturday, June 29th against Weston. Back on June 19th, we just mentioned that 1-0 victory for Daytona, so they'll look to have a little bit of momentum coming into that third game of the five-game homestand. Then on July 3rd, just before Independence Day, we'll be against Florida Elite, and then Saturday, July 6th, against Sarasota, and that will be the final home game of the 2019 regular season for Daytona SC. And we will have a free kick just inches outside of the box. Lined up to take it for Daytona, Donaciano and Duamena, both of them eager to get contact on this ball, send it right into the box. Jeremy Costa is in goal, ready to take it, but he didn't even have to be there as it's sent through the uprights and over the net by Duamena. A beautiful chance early for Daytona. They just weren't able to get the ball on target here in the sixth minute of play, still a 0-0 score. And it will be a free kick right at midfield as an FC Miami player is down just outside the circle. Looking around FC Miami City in the past three games, back on June 8th, it was a 2-4 loss against the Villages, and then they are riding a two-game win streak coming into Daytona. A 4-0 victory against Weston and a 3-1 victory at home against Lakeland. This ball sent all the way into the attacking third for Miami, and they will settle it down on the left corner. Good regroup from Donaciano for Daytona, but he sends it out of play, and it will be a throw-in for FC Miami. Just about 10 yards away from the end line, Paul Harbrecht has to be careful for a cross that comes in, but Seruge is trying to get it on the ground close into the box, unable to do so, and Daytona not able to break it out of their own defensive third, so Miami will have another throw-in. They'll send it all the way back to midfield. A good amount of high-scoring games for FC Miami. I just mentioned that 2-4 loss against the Villages, and then a 4-0, and then 3-1 victory. As this one is sent through the box and all the way to the left side for Daytona to begin out of their defensive third. And again, another play where Daytona just sends it out without making a direct pass. Looking to the next three games for FC Miami, they are on the road against Florida Elite on June 29th. And then they will finish with four straight home games to end out the 2019 season, including July 2nd against the Villages and July 6th against Florida Elite. So nearly two back-to-back games for FC Miami against Florida Elite. But right now, Miami trying to get the ball in the box, and it will be a corner kick for Miami just to the left of Paul Harbrecht, who for the first time this season does not have to start a game facing the sunset. This is the first time Daytona's had the advantage of playing away from the sunset for Harbrecht and trying to get some of that pressure on the opposing team's goalkeeper, but they got to get it out of their defensive third and deal with a penalty, with a corner kick, excuse me, coming into the box through the air, bounces in towards Harbrecht, cleared out but not out of danger, finally all the way out and into midfield for FC Miami to handle control here coming into the ninth minute of play. FC Miami still threatening at the top of the box, comes in, Harbrecht will hang on to that one and quickly play it out to the left side, but too far away from Daytona. FC Miami brings it back the other way on the transition, and finally it will be taken out by Brock Exline on the slide. Smart play from Paul Harbrecht there. Had the ball in his hands on the free kick just outside of the box, but it was just too far away from his winger to make contact and get the ball out of the defensive third for Daytona. And now a goal kick for Harbrecht to get it to midfield or even farther. Ninth minute of play, still looking for our first goal of the match. And Daytona, not a high-scoring team in the first half. Only one first-half goal in the seven games that they have participated in. However, they're a good finishing team. They've got four second-half goals. And if you look at FC Miami on the other side of things, in goals against, FC Miami has given up only two first-half goals this season, while giving up five goals in the second half. So if Daytona can have a good offensive pressure and handle the offensive attack from Miami here in this first half, if the paper holds true, Daytona will have a good chance of putting a couple in the back of the net against Miami and possibly getting a victorious result here on this Friday night matchup. Miami will have it on their right side of the field. The throw-in will go down the line onto the foot of Daytona, and instead it will be a free kick as the referee deemed that not a legal defensive play from Daytona. And it will be Urso to take it for Miami. Just on the attacking side of midfield for Miami. Still a dangerous play if Daytona defense is not careful. This one does come in the box. Harbrecht's going to come out to attack the play. Runs over the Miami attacker. And it will be a penalty against the FC Miami forward that ran into Harbrecht. That is number 7, Igor Martins, who got the yellow card on that dangerous play against Harbrecht. And you saw on the replay there, Harbrecht jumped up to make the play and get it away from Martins, and he was not able to back off of Harbrecht in time to avoid the contact, thus the yellow card handed out in the 11th minute of play. Harbrecht with the left foot will send it over midfield down the left side, and a ball back up in the air will go out of play, last touched by Daytona, so FC Miami will handle possession in the 12th minute. Lots of possession held on the near side of the field, left side for Daytona, right side for FC Miami. Not a lot happening on the far end of the field. And neither team with real solid possession in the attacking third. Daytona had a good 3 or 4 minute stretch where they had trouble getting out of their defensive third. FC Miami with a good amount of possession so far, and they'll send this one all the way through towards the end line, right in on Harbrecht, but he's off of his baseline and able to snag it just as it comes into his box, and he'll send it on the left side. Exline will send it up that left side. He'll get it back. And he'll look over his options, and he'll turn it over. FC Miami now with possession again. Igor Martins down that right side, centers it into the box, cleared out by Daytona all the way to midfield, sent towards the right side. And again, It will be a throw-in for FC Miami. Left line throw-in will be taken by Seruge, and he'll get it back, sends it down the line with the left foot, but it finds the play for Daytona. Andreas Jackson dealing with a two-man pressure. Ball stays in play. Miami wanted a throw-in, but they will get possession nonetheless on the play down that left side. All the way back for Seruge. He'll send it back to his defensive back of Uwad. Back for Trimmingham. Right defender will wear that captain sleeve on the left arm. Sends it all the way to the left line. Play continues for Miami down that left side towards the baseline. Centering a ball towards the top of the box. Cleared out but not out of danger again. Finds Martins. He'll take a shot that gets deflected and will go for a goal kick for Harbrecht. Another dangerous play for FC Miami. Daytona hasn't had much pressure since Duan Mena had that free kick go over the goal back in the sixth minute. Fourteenth minute of play, and Harbrecht will once again send it towards midfield with the left foot. Doesn't find a Daytona teammate until it bounces around a few times. Still no one with clear possession, and then Miami will take it down that right side, and it will be a free kick for Miami again. As Duan Mena got a little bit too much of the Miami forward than the referee would have liked. Back towards midfield, poor touch from Miami, and now Daytona will have a chance on the transition. Hard pressure from number 9, Peralta, for Miami, and that will draw a free kick for Daytona. They'll settle possession down to the left side, almost out of play, stays in bounds, and now will go out of play for another throw-in for Miami. Daytona, now that's the third or fourth time they've just given possession to Miami on a poor touch on the sideline. This through ball will find a player down the right side. That's number 2, Fajardo. Fajardo back to the left side, and a shot gets deflected, I believe. No, they're going to say it didn't deflect. That was number 6, Frederick Gill, who had a play with the left foot on the far side to put it past Harbrecht, but he couldn't find the frame. All of that coming in the 16th minute of play. Still no score between FC Miami City and Daytona Soccer Club. The only statistics on the score sheet so far shows a yellow card for Igor Martins of FC Miami. And now Daytona will have another free kick just as they enter that attacking third. And it will be Shandell Sr. to take it. Not a lot of options, but he'll find Donaciano down the right side, entering the box. He's taken down on the play. No call is given. Referee's going to say he fell down after the contact was made. Daytona will get possession back, however. Lee Flowers will leave it for Donaciano. All the way back to Sr. entering the attacking third. Donaciano again handling it. And a free kick, or excuse me, possession will be called. No free kick given for Daytona. And instead, FC Miami will bring it back down that left side. Lots of physical play being had here by both teams here in the opening 16 minutes. But nothing in the back of the net just yet. Miami working in their defensive half to get the ball out. Good pressure from Daytona, keeping them back in the defensive third. Back to the left side. Good through ball. And it will be an offside call nonetheless, as the intended target was Frederick Gill. Facebook, As I mentioned at the top of the broadcast, Abdullahi with 2 goals on the season will lead the team for Daytona in that category. He's followed by Duamena, Cosine, and Charlton, all with 1 goal on the season thus far. All of that while FC Miami tries to gain the attacking third. Good structure from Daytona, getting them back towards midfield. Meanwhile, Nelson Dume, who is on the bench to start this game for FC Miami, leads Miami with 2 goals on the season. There are 9 other players that have 1 goal on the season, so the wealth is being spread. An onside play here, and this one's kicked over Harbrecht, doesn't find the net, and now it will go in on the right side of the net. I thought Harbrecht was going to have a chance to get there. It was called onside, as I believe that is number 7, Igor Martins, on the left side, who was able to win the race to that ball. As we take a look at an onside play, Martins with the right foot kicks it over Harbrecht, who is not fast enough to get to his end line. He actually lifts his right foot up, thinking his defender was close enough to that play, but it is a 1-0 lead for FC Miami City. All of that in the 19th minute of play. So for the second time in as many home games, Daytona's going to have to trail or play from behind, rather. This one for O'Sullivan, intercepted by Miami, and they will send it back. Back again, left side for Miami. They'll send it back for Trimmingham. Miami defense just playing catch with it now. Trimmingham on that right side. Miami again not wanting to force anything. Finally finds the foot of Daytona all the way back to Harbrecht. He'll send it back out to midfield. O'Sullivan trying to get under it. And it was an offside call just as Daytona was trying to enter the attacking end on that kick from Harbrecht. So Miami will send it back to the right side. Another onside play. On for Martins again. He'll send it into the box, deflected out by Daytona to the left side, and it will be a throw-in for Miami again. Miami with a lot of offensive threatening plays, and Daytona right now just having to get it out of play as their only response. Not a lot of passes being made out of their defensive third to get the transition game going. And FC Miami really taking advantage of that, keeping the pressure on. Entering the 22nd minute of play, coming up on halfway through the first half of play. Centering ball goes over everyone's head. And this one taken out by Donaciano. Deflected out by Miami, and Donaciano will throw it back in. Under possession for Daytona, nearly given away by Jackson. Now Donaciano dealing with 2 offensive pressuremen from FC Miami, and instead it will be an offside play for Daytona to send it out of their defensive third. Harbrecht will have plenty of time to send it out of his goal box. However, it finds the foot of Miami again. Couple of deflections on the way will find a home on the defensive foot of Daytona back up the left side. Daytona taking space as much as they can. Duamena on the right side for Donaciano. He takes the shot, and it goes just over the net. A good strike on the right foot of Donaciano just over the frame, and it will be a goal kick for Miami. Daytona, good pressure on that goal kick. We'll send it back towards the defensive half of Miami, but Miami will be able to settle it down and work on their breakout, getting it onto their offensive half. Hernandez will move it all the way back to Urso. Urso with a little bit of time, moving down that left side. And Miami will be forced all the way back to their defensive half. Frederick Gill down the left side. Back to Uwad. Looking for a clearing play down that left line. Will go out of play, and it will be a throw in for Daytona as Lee Flowers will take it. Strong throw in down the line, went over his intended target, and instead FC Miami will settle it down on their defensive third again. 24th minute of play. 1-0 lead for FC Miami City off the foot of Igor Martins, who was able to beat Harbrecht on a loose ball behind the Daytona defenders back in the 19th minute. Miami again trying to send it into the attacking third. And now Adam Abdullahi with a left arm to the offensive FC Miami player will draw a free kick for Miami. We'll take a look at it again. That left elbow of Abdullahi, enough to take down Craig Campbell for Miami and draw a free kick for the visitors. Again, the Daytona defenders have to be careful. This can get in behind them and be a dangerous save for Harbrecht to have to save. Comes in behind the defenders, left side, goes off the post and wide of the net. Another dangerous play from FC Miami, but Daytona is able to scave that one off and live to fight another day. Stays down 1-0, 26th minute of play. And the right foot from that Miami player just sent it over the crossbar, actually hit the crossbar of the football upright that stands over the soccer goal. Deflected a couple of times. But again, Miami inches away from gathering a 2-0 lead here in the 26th minute. Now Abdullahi with a free kick in the offensive half for Daytona on the left side. Daytona looking to get an equalizer before the end of this first half. Abdullahi in towards the top of the box. Miami gets it out of trouble. And this is just too hard of a touch from Shandell Sr. And it will be a throw in for Miami on the left side. All the way back for Uwad at the top of his own box. He'll send it to the right side for Trimmingham. Trimmingham is forced out of play by Dwamena, but it did hit Dwamena before going out of play, so a throw-in again for Miami on the near side. Juan Fajardo will take it for Miami. Throw in towards midfield, retreated all the way back to the Miami defensive third, goes far side. And will be brought back to midfield, back to the left side, stays in play for Miami down that left line. Frederick Gill, good sliding block from Andreas Jackson, gets that dangerous centering ball out of play, but it will be a throw in retained by FC Miami. back towards midfield, sent back in towards the box, intercepted, and brought right back out on the transition. Goes off the foot of Abdullahi, and FC Miami has it on the attacking third. Ball comes into the box, offside play. Jackson was there to clean up the trash anyways, so Harbrecht will have a free kick at the top of his box due to the offside here in the 29th minute of play. Sun starting to set here in Daytona Beach, Florida, over Larry Kelly Field at Daytona Stadium. Once again, we thank you for joining us here on our YouTube live stream. As Dwan Mena tries to settle that down for Abdullahi, who sends it back up the line for Abdullahi, or excuse me, for Dwan Mena. And instead, FC Miami will regroup down the left side. Down the line, good ball. Better defensive play from Daytona, almost intercepted on the way back to Harbrecht, but he came well off his line to settle it down and roll it with the hands down the left side for Daytona. Brock Exline will send it up and brought right back again. Looking for the stretch play, goes all the way into the attacking third for Daytona. And instead of the connecting pass, it will be a throw-in for Daytona. Donaciano will take it on the right side, and there will be a substitution. Number 18, Sam Coombs, will come in and replace Brock Exline. So a relatively quick substitution for Daytona, bringing Sam Coombs in just 30 minutes into this match. Coombs will settle into that midfield position in the defensive posture as this ball is brought all the way back to the defensive half for Daytona. Ian McCauley will move it to the left side. Intercepted by FC Miami right at midfield. And Peralta taking his time, moving it back towards midfield for Urso. Urso to the left side for Campbell. Campbell with an errant pass will find the foot of Daytona instead of his intended target, and Dwan Mena will begin the transition at midfield down the left side. Abdullahi has it with the right foot. He'll cut in towards center. Abdullahi all the way back to the right side for Donaciano. Donaciano not afraid to take the shot, but a couple too many dribbles. And instead it will go out of play for a throw-in for Daytona. Abdullahi with a shoulder shove to Saruge. And Coombs will have it on the throw-in from Flowers. Back to Flowers, back to Coombs. He'll send it in towards center for Abdullahi. Abdullahi into the box. A dangerous play and a good catch from Costa off his line for FC Miami. Down the left side for Saruge. He'll send it back into the box for Uwad. Uwad taking space that's given to him by O'Sullivan. He'll send it into the attacking half. Finds Peralta. Peralta down the right side for Campbell. Campbell into the box, back up top for Peralta. Peralta takes a shot deflected up in the air, and Harbrecht will make the easy catch and send it up towards center for Abdullahi, who continues it along. Good bump from Donaciano, but again, a little bit too fancy and instead turns the ball over to Miami in the 32nd minute. Miami, as I mentioned earlier, a strong first half defensive team. Only two goals given up in the first half. Definitely more given up in the second half. And Daytona, a better finishing team than they are a starting team, so we'll look to see how they respond from that 19th minute goal from Igor Martins for Miami City as they come into the latter portions of this first half and into the second half. comes all the way for Donaciano on the right side, maintains possession, has a little bit of space coming into the box, stops up on the play. Donaciano back up top for Coombs. Coombs has space down the left side, and we'll find Mike Zamore. Zamore back for Coombs. Retreating all the way back for McCauley. Back on the far side for Zamore. Zamore down the line, looking for Senior, comes into the box. Senior trying to get a handle on it, and instead it is rolled out of play for a goal kick. Once again, in the 34th minute, a 1-0 lead for FC Miami City over Daytona. Played down the right sideline by Miami. They'll continue it along. However, it's intercepted by Zamore, handled by Daytona again. Abdullahi right at the center circle. With a little bit of space, he'll send it down the right side for Donaciano. Does it have the legs to get to the end line? It does. It looked like Donaciano was going to be able to settle it down just before it got to that end line. Instead, it took one too many bounces, and it will result in a goal kick. 35th minute for FC Miami. With the right foot all the way to midfield, FC Miami will settle it. Good pressure from Daytona, though, outnumbering but not able to win the battle right at midfield. Instead, FC Miami will send it back to Trimingham. Urso back to Trimingham. Trimingham down that right sideline. He'll find Fajardo. Back to the defensive half. Hernandez with the switch all the way to Uwad. That one sent all the way to the end line of Daytona. Miami players not really in communication with each other. And instead, Harbrecht is able to send it up the left side for Ian McCauley. And we'll see how Daytona is able to transition up the field. Just about 10 minutes left here in this first half, entering the 36th minute. Good couple of one touches from Daytona on the right side of midfield. Abdullahi will send it back to Andreas Jackson. Back to the right side for McCauley. Senior again back to McCauley. Daytona defense playing catch with it in the defensive half. Jackson has tons of space to move it into center for Abdullahi. Abdullahi for Senior. Still a good amount of room for Daytona to operate at midfield, but not a lot of passing options for the forwards that Daytona is looking to get to. Down the left side for Dwamena. Dwamena dangerously entering the box, looking to the right side for Donaciano. He was wide open and would have had a great look at goal. Instead, deflected out by Miami on a good defensive play. And one more free kick in the 37th minute for Daytona right at midfield. Donaciano's legs are really pumping here in the first half. He's had a good number of chances. Been a little bit too fancy with it at times, but he's putting himself in the right position to get a lot of touches on the ball here in this opening half. And he's calling for the ball every time it gets within 30 yards of him. Donaciano has it. He'll send it into the middle for O'Sullivan. O'Sullivan back to Coombs, and they'll send it to the left side for Zamore. Back for Donaciano on the right side, just too far away from him before it goes out of play for another throw-in for Miami. 38th minute of play, a 1-0 lead for Miami. A 19th minute goal from Igor Martins is the difference here in this opening half. on the far side. Daytona will take over on a turnover. Coombs will have it down the right sideline, pressured all the way back to midfield, almost intercepted by Miami. Instead, we'll find the foot of Abdullahi. Abdullahi down the left side for Zamor. Gets some support from Duamena back to Abdullahi. Abdullahi with a little bit of space, and instead he's taken down on the play, and FC Miami will take over. Miami working out of their defensive half. All the way to midfield, but an errant touch from Miami will give Daytona possession again. Andreas Jackson with a good couple of moves to get possession to the left side for Zamor. Back for Coombs, continued along for McCauley. All the way back for McCauley again. Looking for the switch for Donaciano. Doesn't find the target. Instead, Miami begins their transition. Hernandez to the left side for Sarugue. Sarugue down the line, curling in towards the middle. And the referee will say play on. Right side for Jackson. He'll continue it along for Coombs. Coombs to the left side for Zamor. 40th minute of play. Just about 5 minutes left here in the opening half. FC Miami leading 1-0 over Daytona. Miami will happen right at midfield, all the way on the left sideline. The stoppage will take us all the way to the 42nd. Miami will send it towards midfield to get a better angle of attack. Deflected near side for Fajardo. Fajardo again for Martins. Martins and Fajardo dealing with the defensive pressure of Daytona, trying to get it back, and instead will be a throw in for Daytona. Mike Zamor will take it down that left sideline. Sends it right in for a play by McCauley. McCauley will move it far side for Jackson, back into the middle for Coombs. Back for Jackson down that right sideline. Hard pressure from Miami, forcing a turnover as Lee Flowers was unable to handle that pass. Frederick Gill down the left side, centers it towards the top of the box. Good play from Coombs. Coombs has that one stolen away. Miami back in towards the top of the box. Finally steered out of trouble by Daytona. Brought right back in by Trimmingham. He senses blood in the water, wants to keep the offensive pressure up. Centering pass stays on the turf and cleared out by Jackson. Still under possession of Miami. Almost stolen away by Daytona. Play continues for Trimmingham. Trimmingham back to the left sideline for Gill. 43rd minute of play. Centering ball gets deflected to the left side. No one is home, so this one will have time to go out of play for a throw-in by Miami. Another case of hard forecheck pressure from FC Miami on the defensive backs of Daytona, forcing a turnover, creating a quality scoring chance, but no shot was had. Mohamed Ouad will have it again for FC Miami, moves it all the way back to Costa. Costa at the top of his box will send it with the right foot back to midfield. Takes a huge hop off the turf, and now Senior sends it in, and it was not hard enough to get it to the far side for Duamena, and instead FC Miami will settle it down back on their end line. Costa will force Daytona to pressure him before being forced to pick it up, trying to kill time to get into the locker room at halftime. Again with the right foot down that near sideline. Battled for up in the air, and Daytona will have possession on the 50-50 ball. Jackson, clear turnover, transition for Miami. Down the left side for Peralta. Peralta in towards the line. Peralta cuts in tight. Huge save by Harbrecht, and the ball goes out of play. Harbrecht bailing his team out of trouble. A terrible turnover from Daytona, and once again, they lean on the shoulders of their keeper in the 45th minute. We take a look at that. Andreas Jackson taken out of his boots, and Harbrecht had to make a save as he went down to take as much net away as he could. Harbrecht again standing tall, keeping his team in this game. Daytona will try to get it back in the offensive half. Miami having other plans, however. They'll get possession out to midfield before they're stopped and sent back for a throw-in in their defensive half. As we hit the end of the first half, no stoppage time needed. And that will send the teams into the locker room at the end of the first half, a 1-0 lead for FC Miami City. A lone goal at the 19th minute from Igor Martins, who also picked up a yellow card for FC Miami. Lee Flowers on the score sheet for Daytona, also with a yellow card. We'll be right back for the start of the second half here on our YouTube live stream. Once again, FC Miami leading 1-0 over Daytona SC. second half between Daytona SC and FC Miami City. Miami coming into the second half leading by a score of 1-0 over Daytona. Igor Martins with a 19th minute goal is the difference maker thus far. One yellow card for each team. Igor Martins also on the score sheet with a yellow card for Miami, and Lee Flowers the yellow card for Daytona. Daytona in their home full neon kit will be moving left to right across the field at your vantage point on the computer screen. Paul Harbrecht in the orange jersey in goal for Daytona. FC Miami in the white uniforms with the black pants and socks, moving in the opposite direction, right to left across the field. As this header comes right in on goal, Harbrecht eager to make the save and send it with the left foot all the way over midfield into the attacking third. Bounces right in front of Dwamena, and Dwamena will have possession on the left sideline. Dwamena coming right into the box. He's taken down on the play, but ball was hit first. And so a penalty, or a goal kick rather, and now a little bit of pushing and shoving on the far side of the box. All of the shoves coming from the FC Miami player. And we'll see if they keep the corner kick on the left side of the field. And I believe the referee giving the lecture to both players. Looks to be number 44, Josiah Trimmingham, along with number 73, Paolo Urso. I believe it was number 73, Urso, who was the recipient of that yellow card that was just handed out. On the shoves to Dwamena, as the corner kick comes curling towards the goal line, and a save and a catch was made by Jeremy Costa. As now, I believe that's another yellow card given out to FC Miami. Not sure who the recipient is. But now Daytona with a glorious scoring chance here to open the second half. Adam Abdullahi looking to add to his team-leading goals, two goals on the season, will take this penalty kick in the 48th minute. Still some pushing and shoving from Dwamena and a couple of FC Miami players. Now a yellow card given to an FC Miami sub on the side of the field. Still more jawing coming from FC Miami's bench. That's the holdup right here off camera right now. The entire FC Miami bench up in arms at the referee. So three different yellow cards given out to three different FC Miami players in the span of about a minute will lead to a penalty kick for Adam Abdullahi. All of this now will finally spring the penalty kick in the 50th minute. Abdullahi lined up to take it with the right foot. Abdullahi with the shot, and he scores off the penalty kick. Abdullahi ties it up for Daytona. 50th minute penalty kick goal for the equalizer. And as we look at that replay, the right foot of Abdullahi sends it across his body to the left side of his net. Had Jeremy Costa diving well out of the way. And it's a tie game, 1-1 in the 50th minute. So a quick start in the second half here for Daytona. Ties it up 1-1 entering the 50th minute of play. Daytona will again have possession on the passing attempt from FC Miami that went awry. Abdullahi, the goal scorer. Two goals in as many games, both of them penalty kicks, both of them in the second half. Miami on the transition. Back to the right side for Miami. They want to get the lead back and in a hurry. Sent out of play by Zamore for Daytona, so it will be a Miami throw-in on the right side. And all Daytona has to do right now, it seems, is to keep their composure. Three yellow cards given out to Miami in the span of about 90 seconds that led to that penalty kick goal from Abdullahi. Miami with good possession in the attacking third, sends it into the box, headed out of trouble on the diving play. I believe that was Andreas Jackson, it was, who sent that one on a diving Superman play over the net. Will result in a corner kick for Miami, however. Corner kick will be taken on the far side. Will move from left to right across the body of Harbrecht. And as we take a look at that diving play again from Jackson, completely horizontal, this corner kick went crossing off the head of Abdullahi, and it will spring a corner kick opposite side to the near side for FC Miami again. Everyone crowding that box comes right in, saved by Harbrecht, and he'll get it out of trouble again. And now the referee is set to give another yellow card. I believe this one will go in the way of number two, Juan Fajardo, for FC Miami. I apologize that I do not have the yellow cards given out during the penalty kick, but what I can tell you is that Urso and Fajardo and Martins all have yellow cards, as well as one of these subs for FC Miami and another one added on top of that. There is at least five yellow cards given out to FC Miami so far, and Harbrecht and Abdullahi carrying Daytona right now here in the 53rd minute, tying the game at 1-1. Miami looking to settle the play down for a throw-in on the right side. Out of their defensive half, they'll move it towards midfield. And this one does get deflected off of a neon jersey back out of play. Fajardo will move it all the way back to Trimmingham. Trimmingham was looking for Martins down the right side, but Martins wasn't moving nearly fast enough, so Harbrecht is able to send it to the right side for Jackson. Jackson up the middle, goes back to Harbrecht, continues on to the left side for McCauley. McCauley with the right foot will send it down the line looking for Dwamena. Trimmingham comes in to intercept, goes all the way back to his own corner. Dwamena, he's held down on the play, and instead Dwamena will receive that penalty, and a free kick for Miami will ensue. All the way out towards midfield, but held by Daytona. Sam Coombs all the way back to Andreas Jackson, and he'll settle it up the right side. Another turnover from Jackson. Back in the first half, he had a turnover that nearly went in the back of his net that had to be saved by Harbrecht. There's another turnover that will spring a transition from Miami. We are even at 1-1 in the 56th minute. And the last time these two teams played, back on May 29th in Miami, this was the final score, a 1-1 draw. Currently, Daytona with three draws on the season. Miami City, their only draw is that 1-1 game back on May 29th against Daytona. O'Sullivan back on the right side. He's taken down on the play, so that's a free kick down the right sideline in the attacking third, but there is a Miami player down at midfield as well. And that will bring the training staff out to midfield on the near side. Unable to make out a number of the Miami player down at midfield on all fours. This could be a dangerous crossing attempt for Daytona if they can get one high enough into the box. O'Sullivan, Dwamena, along with Senior and McCauley, all in the box, ready to get on the receiving end of this free kick cross. And that is number four, Fernando Hernandez. As we take a look at the collision that sent Hernandez down, collided with his right side awkwardly against Shandell Sr. That will force him off the field for the next couple of seconds until he's brought back in by the referee. So right now, FC Miami playing with 10 men until Hernandez comes back out onto the turf. Abdullahi with the right foot, sends it low, deflected, comes into the box, a header and a save made by Costa right on the goal line, and he'll quickly send it high in the air and deflected right back towards midfield by Daytona. O'Sullivan will move it to the left side, had to be played out by Dwamena, protesting his case for his team to have the throw in. Instead, Miami will settle it on their right side. Fajardo right at midfield. Sent into the center circle. Daytona nearly with a transition. Instead, settled down by Miami again. Dwamena on the back check, unable to steal it away from Martins. Martins unable to get around the defensive play of McCauley, and that will spring Abdullahi down the near side. Donaciano will retreat all the way back to Andreas Jackson. Back for Flowers. Down the right side for Donaciano, deflected out by Miami, and a throw-in for Flowers down that right sideline. Almost intercepted by Daytona on the regroup from Miami, instead sent out to the defensive half of Daytona. Miami trying to get some offensive traction again. Settled down by Coombs. Towards midfield for Senior. Back to the left side for Zamore. That pass from Zamore went through Senior. They were both looking for a Dwamena on the third man. Instead, it goes out of play, and Miami will have a throw-in. And Miami is looking for a two-man substitution at the next halt of play. All the way up for Senior. Senior to the far side, Abdullahi and Donaciano will give chase. Donaciano gets there, Abdullahi now centering it into the box, deflected out by Miami, and curling all the way to midfield and out of play, and that will allow Miami to get their substitution in the 60th minute. Entering this match in the 60th minute will be number 20, Miguel Perez, and number 32, Martin Marijuan. Exiting the match will be number 17, Craig Campbell, and number 6, Frederick Gill. Daytona with possession on the throw-in, deflected back out by Miami. And Zamore will have another throw-in on the left side for Daytona right at midfield. All the way down that left sideline, deflected back under possession of Miami, sent through the air. And right back out of play for another throw-in by Miami, 61st minute of play. 1-1 tied game, the first goal coming from FC Miami back in the 19th minute from Igor Martins. And then a 50th minute penalty kick from Adam Abdullahi, his third of the season, and second penalty kick goal in the second half in as many nights. Senior taking able to take his man down on the field. Legally, the referee says, and it will be a throw-in for Daytona on the left side. All the way back for McCauley to settle it down for Jackson. Jackson changing the angle of attack over to the right side of the turf for Daytona. Back to the left side for McCauley. McCauley at the top of his box, not a lot of options, so he'll go back for Jackson. Jackson will continue it for O'Sullivan, looking for some support from Abdullahi, and he'll find it. Good ball protection from Abdullahi, looking down the right side, deflected out by Miami. And Flowers will have a throw-in on that right side, back for Abdullahi. Continued along by Coombs, finds a man up top. Senior has it at the top of the box, unable to get a shot. Goes far side, Flowers is there, keeps it in play. At the corner, continues back up towards midfield. One-timer comes into the box. Senior has it with the left foot, fans on it. O'Sullivan with a chance, he's unable to get a foot on it. Now Donaciano, he's harassed by three white jerseys, and Miami's able to get it back with speed down the right side for Martins. He's already got one goal in this match, looking for another. Martins down the right side all the way to the end line. Stays in play, says the line judge. And a pass is intercepted by Miami again. Murray Juan up to the top of the box. Takes the right foot shot. Huge save from Harbrecht. Keeps it a 1-1 game. Diving play to his left for Harbrecht in the 63rd minute. Keeps it a 1-1 game. Will spring a corner kick for Miami. That shot came off the right foot of Paolo Urso. And there's that left-handed diving save as a corner kick comes in. Punched away by Harbrecht. It was going to drop on that far post from the corner kick. Instead, Harbrecht able to get a hand on it and send it out of trouble. And now Donaciano's taken down on the play. Will we see a sixth yellow card? We will. So it will be a free kick for Daytona right at midfield again. They'll quickly get the ball in motion, looking for Sam Coombs. Instead, the referee had his eye elsewhere. So we'll redo the free kick, back onto the foot of Coombs. Jackson to the left side for McCauley. Up the field to the left side for Zamore. Zamore switching the angle of attack to the right side, intercepted by Miami. They'll get it on the left side. All the way back for Mohamed Ouad. 65th minute of play. 20 minutes gone here in half number two. 1-1 tied game between FC Miami City and Daytona SC. Down the right side, Miami unable to get it into the box, deflected out of play by Ian McCauley, and another corner kick for Miami here in that 65th minute.
Entering the game for Miami, Nicholas Gilliard.
And one more substitution made by FC Miami. Entering is number 88, Nicholas Gouliard. And exiting the match was number 7, Igor Martins. Another corner kick punched away by Harbrecht. And that ball sent out of the stadium into the trees on the deflection. Lots of movement happening around Harbrecht. Again, Dwamena at the center of that. Nicholas Gouliard fresh off the bench, harassing the Daytona goalkeeper. This one's deflected out of the box. Abdullahi with the head back towards center, intercepted by Miami. Over to the left side, lots of room on that side. The left foot pass comes into the box. Harbrecht out of position, sent off of a body, and an offside play saves the day for Daytona. Down on the turf was McCauley, who had that one sent, that clearing attempt sent right off of his backside. And I believe he is down holding his lower body. He was already down before that clearing attempt came and deflected off of him. And that will require the training staff to take a look at Ian McCauley here in the 67th minute. Lots of offensive pressure from Miami. Entering the 67th minute, still a 1-1 game. That now makes 5 second-half goals for Daytona on this season, and that will rise the goals against total for FC Miami in the second half to 6. So exactly as it came out on paper, Daytona did concede 1 goal in the first half, but they were able to make that strong push here in this second half. They found the equalizer, and they still have another 20 minutes and then some to try to get that go-ahead goal. Harbrecht is ready to send this ball to midfield. 68th minute of play. Harbrecht with the left foot got a little bit too much spin on it. Sent it out of play. Daytona never even had a chance to get possession. So Miami on the throw-in on the near side. Looking to get it under control all the way back in their defensive half now. Trimmingham sends it towards the end line, an offside play, as the intended target was Mary Juan down the right side. Harbrecht will come out and send it with the left foot himself. And now there is still an issue with Ian McCauley. He is going to have to be taken out of this game, I believe. And we'll see who he will be replaced by. Number 19, Nelson Puskin, is primed to come into this match. Right now, Daytona playing with one man down. They're only playing with 10 men as Ian McCauley is on the sideline being looked at. So until Daytona can get this ball out of play, they're shorthanded here in the 70th minute. And FC Miami knows that they want to get some offensive pressure going while Daytona's shorthanded. Miami looking to attack the box, and instead an errant pass will go off the left foot and out of play. And Puskin will enter this match. Back to 11 each side. Daytona throwing on that right side. Handled by Flowers. Flowers down the line. Held by Abdullahi. Almost fell down on the transition. Now Donaciano nearly had it stripped. And Daytona looking down the line, but it was an offside play nonetheless. Trimmingham changing the angle of attack to the left side, and again, Daytona is able to send it out of play for a throw-in from Miami in the attacking third. Gouliad will handle that throw-in, intercepted by Daytona. Donaciano for Abdullahi. Abdullahi harassed from behind by two white jerseys. The shot comes in but goes over the net. Harbrecht was there to make the save. Goal kick will proceed for Paul Harbrecht here in the 72nd minute. Still a 1-1 tied game. One more substitution primed and ready to take place. Craigton Charlton at the next stoppage will come in for Daytona. However, Miami with possession down the right side. Marijuan up top in the box. Left foot gets deflected on that shot, and it goes over the end line and out of play. And it will be a corner kick for Miami. Once again, moving left to right across Harbrecht's keeper box. Curling towards the goal line, deflected off of a Miami player towards the end line, comes back into the top of the box. Shot gets deflected away by Daytona out of trouble. Comes all the way back up top. Stolen away. Daytona has numbers down the left side. Duamena. He's got a man on the far side. That's Donaciano. Donaciano down that right side, unable to get a shot. Centering for Duamena, didn't get any kind of contact on it that sent it towards the frame. And Daytona is unable to capitalize on the best chance they've had all game, minus the penalty kick goal from Abdullahi. A partial two-on-one outnumbered situation. Duamena with the left foot unable to get solid contact. And that is the last play that Duamena will make on his night. He is the man that is being replaced by Craigton Charlton. So instead, FC Miami will have a transition opportunity down the left side. And this is a dangerous one. Good play from Puskin. And Daytona will send it up that right side. Flowers. He'll send it on an offside play. Would have been a wide open net for O'Sullivan. Instead, it's an offside called against Daytona. And that's a close one. Miami quickly getting the ball back in motion for Hernandez. He'll send it down the right side, gets deflected by a head of a Daytona defender, comes on the foot of Harbrecht, and he'll settle the play down at the top of his box. 75th minute, still a tied 1-1 game between Daytona and Miami. Harbrecht will settle the play down outside of his box with the left foot. He'll send it into midfield, but no neon jersey was within 10 yards of that landing area, so Miami will settle it down the right side. Up the sideline, good read from Daytona as Senior gets it up to Coombs. Coombs into the middle for O'Sullivan. O'Sullivan down the left side again for Coombs. Coombs with the left foot centers it all the way to the far side for Charlton. Abdullahi comes in for support. Instead, it's an offside call either way. Abdullahi pleading his case, but the call has already been made. And in the 76th minute, FC Miami will have a free kick just outside the keeper box. And the Miami defense will change the angle of attack to the right side of the field. Trimmingham back towards center. Hernandez changing to the left side. Sarugue back in towards center. And Perez looking for that centering play, intercepted by Harbrecht, and he will have it at the top of the box. Towards the right sideline for Craigton Charlton. He'll send it off a body of a Miami defender on for Senior. Senior back towards the right sideline. Not a lot of support. Good back check for Miami. Stolen away by Daytona. O'Sullivan at the top of the box trying to get it in. And instead it's sent out towards midfield. Settled down by Abdullahi out of the air. Coming in to the box again. And instead it's a free kick for Miami. You're going to say that Donaciano had a little bit too much physicality getting under that landing spot. That one nearly goes out of play. Instead handled by Sam Coombs. Back to Zamore, all the way back to Harbrecht. Hard pressure coming from Miami. Harbrecht has to quickly send it with the left foot. And easily sent back into the attacking half for Miami. No one with clear possession. Andreas Jackson taken down, trying to maintain it. And finally, Daytona will send it up the right side with plenty of time. Craigton Charlton, able to get around the first man, cutting in towards center. Able to get around the second man. To the right side for Abdullahi. Abdullahi with a crossing attempt comes in. There's three players in the box. Comes up top for O'Sullivan. Daytona's unable to get a shot on target again. 78th minute coming into the final 12 minutes of play. And another substitution for Miami. Now their leading scorer at 2 goals in 8 games, Nelson Dume, will enter this match for Miami. Daytona with the throw in. Coombs will retreat all the way back to Puskin. Right side for Jackson. All the way back to the near side for Zamore. Up the left sideline for Donaciano. He's taken down on the play. And an easy free kick call in favor of Daytona right at midfield. Now Nate Monsanto primed to come into this match for Daytona. At the next stoppage of play, that substitution will ensue. Play in the 79th minute, a 1-1 tied game between Daytona and Miami. Near side for Zamore. Zamore's able to get to that ball before it goes out of play, pressured hard and forced into a turnover. Now Miami trying to transition with numbers, unable to do so. Good pressure from Coombs, and instead that's a free kick awarded to Miami. They'll quickly get the ball in motion. Miscommunication from Miami, however, and that will allow Harbrecht to let the ball go out of play and allow his team to make a substitution for Monsanto to enter the match. And it looks like he will be replacing number 9, Joe O'Sullivan. That is an 80th minute substitution. And that ball is deflected out of play by Miami on the right side for Daytona to have the throw in. Abdullahi will give it to Flowers for the throw in. back for Abdullahi. Continues it all the way back to Coombs. Coombs has that pass intercepted. Monsanto on the back check, able to force a turnover for Flowers. And Coombs has that one deflected off of his lower body and out of play. So Miami able to get out of their defensive end, but not without some pressure coming from Daytona. They'll get it into the attacking half, and a tumbling Miami player is able to get a free kick as they are just entering their attacking third. They'll send it to the right side for Fajardo. Fajardo all the way to the sideline for Mary Juan. He'll send it into the box, gets deflected a couple of times, cleared out by Daytona. Charlton goes soaring through the air to get that one for Monsanto to send it to Abdullahi. Abdullahi down the sideline, no one is home, but finds Charlton on the deflection. Daytona on the transition. Senior, he'll take the shot well wide of the target. And it will be a goal kick for Jeremy Costa. He will quickly get it in play for Trimmingham. Down the right sideline again for Mary Juan. Good play from Puskin to get it out of danger. Quick throw in about to come from Miami. Comes into the middle for Dume. Dume with the left foot sends it off the body of Senior back out of play. And it will be another throw in for Urso. 83rd minute of play. Urso with the left foot. Now there's going to be another card. This one for Donaciano. A yellow card. As he shoved down the Miami player right in front of the referee. As there is definitely some bad blood between these two teams. And we'll take a look at that replay. Donaciano coming in on that throw-in. He'll get right back up and shove down. I believe that's number 32, Mary Juan, again. And a free kick for Miami. Urso with the left foot will send it into the box. Goes through the air. Deflects wide of the goal and sent out by Daytona. Are they able to get there before it goes out of play? No, the line judge will signal it out in the Daytona defensive half. Fajardo up that right sideline. Fajardo comes in for support. Instead, Daytona is able to have a throw in, able to get the ball out of trouble. And enough protesting from Miami. We will redo that throw in for Daytona. They're going to say that Zamora encroached too far up the sideline towards his attacking half. And again, some more pushing and shoving. Craigton Charlton, the voice of reason for Daytona, getting Shandell Sr. out of that jawing match. And now a yellow card again. I believe that one for Martin Marijuan for FC Miami. A lot of paperwork for this referee this evening after this match is finished with. Still at least 5 minutes to play here, and another free kick for FC Miami, and now a lot more pushing and shoving right in front of the referee. Things have got to get settled down here. I believe that was Donaciano with one final shove. And we'll see what comes from all of this. Right now, there are no cards being handed out. I can only assume that the referee is thinking over his decisions. This all in the 86th minute, still a tied 1-1 game. This game is still fully up for grabs. And with the ball in the Daytona defensive half, you have to do anything you can to get this ball out of trouble. And this free kick primed to come just a few yards away and outside of the keeper box. I didn't see any cards handed out from that scuffle at all. So we'll just have a free kick for Miami just outside of the Daytona box, entering the 87th minute. Urso is going to take it for Miami. And again, got to be careful with all that shoving happening in the scrum in front of Harbrecht inside the box. Two-man wall for Daytona, trying to block that centering pass. With the left foot curling in towards the goal, deflected away by Daytona. They'll get it out of trouble. Deflected out, they will say, by Miami, rather, and a throw in for Daytona. Charlton will leave it, and there will be one final substitution for Daytona. Angel Lombardo will come into this match. And he will replace Iracozzi Donaciano. Eighty-eighth minute of play. Time becoming an enemy of both teams right now. I'm sure they both want to get those full 3 points. This ball comes in towards the box. Nearly comes in. Now it does come in to the hands of Harbrecht. He had to be careful on that one, on an errant clearing attempt from Daytona. If Daytona is able to get all 3 points, they will move up to 15 points and into second place. If Miami is able to pick up the 3 points, they will skyrocket themselves even farther into first place than they already are. Now another two-man scrum right in front of the Daytona bench. Mike Zamora is down holding his left leg. He's able to pop back up before play is halted, so it will continue in the Miami defensive half. 89th minute on the field, still a tied 1-1 game. And now this is going to be another card here for Daytona. I believe it was a handball that is going to be called. And it will be a red card handed out following that second yellow. So Lee Flowers getting his second yellow of the match. And Daytona is down to 10 men coming into the 90th minute, and a free kick for Miami. So Daytona with their backs against the wall. Let's see if they can get another one out of trouble and try to get some offensive momentum. Still waiting for the referee to give the okay. I believe the referee is going to wait all the way until Flowers is into the locker room area. In comes the free kick with the left foot, comes into the box, deflected. Harbrecht is there to send it and direct it out of play, and it will be a corner kick for Miami, as we have now entered stoppage time. Clock has stopped at 90 minutes. Looking like 5 minutes of stoppage time will be added here. We'll keep an eye on that as best as we can. Clock has stopped at 90. We are in stoppage time. Leaf Flowers with a double yellow card, followed by the red card. Daytona down to 10 men, tied at 1-1 against FC Miami. Harbrecht with the left foot gets it out to midfield again. Under control for Miami, they have the man advantage for the remainder of this game. All the way back to Uwad again. Marijuan down the right sideline. He'll find Peralta. Peralta inching towards that end line, and it will be deflected out, I believe, by Senior. So another corner kick for Miami. About a minute and a half into stoppage time. Corner kick moving left to right in the box for Harbrecht. Curling in towards goal, deflected in the air, and it will be a free kick for Daytona, signaled by the official as Abdullahi is down on the turf. And that will stop the clock once again on the wrist of the referee as a trainer comes out to take a look at Adam Abdullahi. Getting that right leg stretched out by his keeper. Too many yellow cards to count for FC Miami and Daytona in this Friday night matchup. All I can tell you is that Lee Flowers got his second yellow card just a few moments ago, earning himself a red card. Daytona down to 10 men and will be down to 9 men unless they're able to get a substitution by the time Abdullahi makes it off the field, and that will be the case. Justin June will have enough time to make it into the match and substitute out Adam Abdullahi. So Daytona will not go more shorthanded than they already are, still with 10 men on the field. And now with that stoppage, no telling how much time the referee is willing to add to this tied match. Still a 1-1 tied game in stoppage time. It was signaled at 5 minutes. And now a free kick signaled by the sideline judge. And Miami will have a free kick just inside their offensive half. Daytona looked to have a little bit of offensive traction, instead brought back by Miami. Ball still not in play yet in stoppage time. Harbrecht directing defensive traffic. And we will have another delay as a pair of players are getting a lecture again from the men in blue. Once again, there was 5 minutes signaled by the referee. That will be over in about 1 minute. But again, no telling how much stoppage time there actually is, as we had Abdullahi take at least 60 seconds to get off the field for an injury, and however much time gets taken off there. As this one gets deflected, Harbrecht makes the save, trying to get a quick transition. Sends it with the left foot, looking for Charlton, intercepted by Miami. Back to the left side for Lombardo. Lombardo on an onside play for Charlton, continues left side for Coombs. Coombs for Charlton in the middle looking for Lombardo, unable to find the target. Miami comes back down the right side. Now a shove right there to the midsection. Down goes Mike Zamore. And I will be surprised if that player's not tossed out. It is a red card for Paolo Urso. Not even a second yellow card, went straight to the red card, the official did. So Urso is out of this match. Miami coaching staff up in arms. Now players having a discussion back in the Daytona defensive half. As this free kick will come from Miami. Now it's 10 aside. No one has a man advantage on the field. Again, we are over 5 minutes of stoppage time played. That's what was signaled. Not sure how much more time the referee is going to give. And that is the game. So no more extra time added by the referee for all the extra stoppages in extra stoppage time. Instead, the referee, with already enough paperwork to handle for the rest of the night, will call it there. Another 1-1 draw between these two teams. Daytona will move to 3-1-4 for 13 points on the season. Meanwhile, FC Miami moving to 5-2-2 and 17 points on the season in one of the most entertaining and physical matches we've ever seen in this 2019 inaugural season for Daytona. And that is a strong way to start this five-game homestand against the top team in your division with four more home games left in this homestand. We will be back right here at Daytona Stadium on Tuesday, June 15th at 7:30 against Lakeland. Last time Lakeland and Daytona played, it was again a 1-1 draw back on the first game of the season for Daytona on May 11th. Once again, we thank you for joining us here on our YouTube live stream. I'm Nick Gimble, bringing you all of the play-by-play action. We thank you for joining us. Enjoy your night. We will see you right back here on Tuesday, June 25th.